Hello everyone, this is Deepak on behalf of our LMS team, Dr. Manish Pote and Mr. Baba Solda, I am presenting this session on KJSC LMS using Moodle for Engineering Education. This is the overview of our session. I will discuss about our college in brief, and then we will understand how we are using Moodle as a learning management system for engineering education in our college. He is our founder, Sri K.J. Somayaji. He was a visionary and he set up various educational institutes in almost all areas of education, from schooling, humanities, basic sciences, Buddhist studies, Jainism, Sanskrit, vocational training, engineering and technology, medicine, nursing, physiotherapy, management, and teacher's education. Our college, KJ Somaiya College of Engineering, was founded in 1983 by Somaiya Vidya Vihar Trust, which came into existence in 1959. It's a trust which is chaired by industrialists, and we have Gujarati linguistic minority. Our college is a constituent college of Somaiya Vidya Vihar University, and we offer 5 undergraduate programs, 6 postgraduate programs, and we have 3 PhD research centers. Let us understand how we are using Moodle as an LMS in our engineering education. We have set up our Moodle in our data center, and we have configured it for our own use, and we have mapped it to a public IP so that our faculty and students can use it anytime, anywhere outside our campus also. And we have used very basic simple theme to keep it as simple as possible. We have integrated our Moodle LMS with Google Apps for Education, so our students can sign in with Somaiya Gmail ID also. This is the summary of all our active users and courses. We have around 1000 courses. Total students actively participating 3689, which includes 600 alumni students. Total teachers 182. Along with support staff, we cater to 6 engineering departments, and we have been using this LMS since August 2018. Let us understand our courses, announcements, and study material. So this is the course landing page where we have almost all features for the students and teachers: navigation, calendar, recent courses, course overviews, administration, and announcement. So this is the sample course page for Advanced Internet Technology, a course where teacher can share all material with the students. So this is how teachers can use this for sharing e-resources, experiments, videos, and attendance, and so on. These are the announcements, how teachers send announcement to the students, and they can keep track of these announcements, how many people have read and commented, and so on. This is showing how sample notes can be shared with the students. Our teachers use it for various active learning strategies, like one is flipped classroom, activity-based learning, wherein teachers share videos with students and ask them to go through these videos before coming to the actual class. And in the class, the actual discussion and problem solving and higher order Bloom's taxonomy levels can be addressed. This is the sample assignment, how it is shared and how it is graded by the teachers. We actually make use of rubrics facility for creating and grading assignments and experiments of students. This is a sample rubric which is created by a teacher for evaluation of an assignment which have to be submitted by the students. And we share these rubrics to the students in advance, so that they know how they will be evaluated. Accordingly, they can design and submit their experiments and assignments. We use this LMS for also delivering differentiated instructional strategies for students with physical and learning disabilities by sharing with them material, different type of material like slides with comments and giving them different deadlines, extending deadlines for them so that it helps them in their learning as well. Our teachers also make use of attendance module, where the regular attendance of all our sessions is submitted through this Moodle. And at the end of the month, at the end of the session, at the end of the term, we can generate various types of reports. And then these reports can be shared with students and administrators for further processing. Regular notifications are also sent to students regarding their attendance through integration of email with this LMS. So this way, email warnings and notifications can be sent to the students regarding their attendance at the end of the session or at the end of the month. So this is just showing how we configure it for sending notifications to the students. And then we export the entire reports for display and then for further processing. Teachers also use our LMS for gamification of courses to make these courses interesting for the students. One such example is shown here, where a teacher has designed a crossword for students to make it interesting for them to participate in a particular course. We also conduct regular quizzes and regular evaluations in a secured manner by using a tool called a Safe Exam Browser. This makes it easy for a teacher and allows students to only focus on one window and give the exam. They cannot move out of this window because of the secured exam and secured quiz. So this is one such example where this quiz is shown, and then it can be seen, the performance of the students can be seen. This is the tool which we use for doing this kind of secure exam or secure quiz. So this is how a teacher can see the performance of the students and then accordingly guide them with respect to where they were not good. We have also integrated our Moodle LMS with other tools and other features to facilitate better learning and processes. One such example is Virtual Programming Lab, which is used for programming courses. Like an example here shown is programming in C, which is the first year basic course in programming, where a teacher can use this tool to explain syntax and semantics of any particular programming language and show the sample outputs with the students. Our Moodle LMS also has been integrated with Google Assignment for generating, sharing coursework and creating assignments for our students and making them submit through Google Classroom using LMS. So this is a screenshot showing how this integration is done by a teacher to create an assignment and give it to the students for their submission and evaluation. So this is the assignment setup. This is experiment setup. This is eventually uploading a shared document with details, and then evaluation can be done and the grades can be shared with the students. We also make use of our LMS for students to give course feedback and exit surveys at the end of their course or at the end of their program. So this is a sample course exit survey where a teacher can create an exit survey questionnaire, and students will be asked to give responses, and these responses can be actually used for further analysis and improvement in the procedures. This is showing a sample questionnaire created by the teacher. And then the responses can be actually collated and extracted and sent to any particular format to be used for further analysis and further processing. Some reports and statistics of our Moodle LMS usage. Around 1,000 courses, more than 3,600 students, 182 teachers, 29 support staff, catering to six engineering departments and being used since August 2018. So this is the statistics page, which shows courses department wise and summary of courses. This is activity per user for all active courses. We have noticed that the student participation has actually increased, and there's a better engagement with students because of this kind of an LMS system. This is active courses, again activity per course, how students are actively participating in each of the courses. All activity per different roles, all activity per different user roles with respect to certain period. That's all from us. Thank you very much. In case there is time, we can certainly take some questions. Thank you.